Namaskar and welcome to e-news of IPR department. I'm Manisha, presenting you all the news bulletin. The Martyrs Day was observed throughout the state of Sikkim with 2 minutes silence in memory of those who gave their lives in the struggle of India's freedom today. At Tasseling Secretariat, Chief Secretary Sri S.C. Gupta observed Martyrs Day along with the officers and staff assembled in front of Tasseling Secretariat. The participant observed 2 minutes silence as a mark of respect to the father of the nation and all the freedom fighters. On this day, every year we celebrate Martyrs Day to honor the sacrifices made by the countless brave Indians who sacrificed their lives for the nation. It is a day ripe to remember the ideals that these valiant souls sacrificed their lives for: justice, liberty, equality and fraternity. Sikkim has become the first state in the country to launch the Rural Management Curriculum for Bachelor's and Master's degree in collaboration with Mahatma Gandhi National Council of Rural Education under the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. The curriculum was officially launched by the Honorable Minister of Education Sri Kunganima Lepcha at his chamber in Tasseling Secretariat yesterday. Briefing the gathering about the curriculum, MGNCRE Chairman Dr. Kumar informed that the Rural Management Curriculum is a BBA-MBA program that strives to promote rural studies and rural management in order to enable development of sustainable rural livelihoods. The unique program aims to equip rural youth with management skills focusing on rural sector while also providing faculty development, support and hand-holding of the universities who will adopt the curriculum in the coming days, he added. Dr. Kumar stated that the curriculum has been initiated in consultation with the best institutes of the country and further added that the state of Sikkim has also been instrumental in the development of the curriculum. Minister Sri Lepcha expressed gratitude to MRNCRE for developing an innovative curriculum and congratulated all for the honor received by the state in being the first in the country to have launched the curriculum. Honorable Minister for Agriculture, Horticulture, Animal Husbandry and Veterinary Services, IPR and Printing and Stationery Department, Shri Lok Nath Sharma is on 4 days official visit of Tamil Nadu. During his tour, the minister is scheduled to visit important government and private farms of agriculture, horticulture and animal husbandry and veterinary services in the state of Tamil Nadu. Thereafter, he shall visit Amul and other dairy units in the state of Kerala. A sub-divisional level coordination meeting chaired by the Honorable Area MLA cum Honorable Minister Roads and Bridges and Culture Department Sri Samdup Lepcha with all government officials, government employees, officers of other organizations including Army, GREF, ITBP, hydropower companies and other central government officers was held at Chungthang on 29th January. The coordination meeting was called on the direction of Honorable Area MLA to discuss on various issues related betterment of the subdivision and also to deliver better services to general public. Direction was given for projection of future developmental prospects by every department and also to monitor and follow up ongoing works to ensure timely completion of the sanctioned project. Minister also insisted to work in close coordination with all organizations and to provide them necessary help and support while delivering services to our local people. It was also decided to have a similar coordination meeting in every 3 months, wherein every department will bring their employee chart and also present the status of all schemes and programs under them. Minister Sri Lepcha also inspected the ongoing construction of the 360-foot Munsithang Baili suspension bridge, which will serve as a lifeline between Lachen and rest of the state. He travelled along the entire length of the bridge on foot and took the stock of ongoing construction of the bridge, which is being jointly built by 86 RCC and Corps of Engineering. On 28 January, the General Officer Commanding in Chief, Eastern Command, Lieutenant General Shri Anil Chauhan, along with GOC Sukhna Best 33 Three Sakti Corps, Lieutenant General Shri Navke Kanduri, and GOC 17 Mountain Division Gantok, Major General R.C. Tiwari, called on Honorable Governor Shri Ganga Prasad at Raj Bhavan. The Army Commander briefed the Honorable Governor about present security situation at Sikkim borders, and he mentioned situation is peaceful. The Honorable Governor appreciated Army efforts at Nathula for rescuing thousands of tourists and providing them basic administrative facilities during emergency. The Governor has also given best wishes to General Officer Commanding in Chief, Eastern Command, for his tenure at Kolkata-based Army Formation. A meeting was conveyed on 20th January by the State Chief Secretary Sri S.C. Gupta to discuss the state's preparedness with regard to the coronavirus. Chief Secretary in his address said that the meeting was conveyed to seek preventive measures and cautions against and suspected case of coronavirus and to assess the preparedness of prevention of any outbreak. He urged the head of departments and all stakeholders to be alert and work in close coordination. DG cum Principal Director Health Dr. P.T. Bhutia briefed about the current status of coronavirus and countries affected by it and also apprised about the precautionary measures already in place under the supervision of the State Health Department, especially in the border areas of Rampur and Singtam and parts of West Sikkim. He also laid down the do's and don'ts for everyone to take into serious consideration for effective prevention. Dr. Bhutia reiterated that there was no need to panic as the virus has not entered India. Furthering the cause of education and aligning it with the vision of the Chief Minister of Sikkim, the District Administration West Sikkim sent two groups of 54 meritorious students, each of class 8 of government schools across the districts to Orissa and Gujarat for a student exposure and learning program titled Explore and Learn. The student exposure program commenced on the 25th of January 2020 and will conclude on the 5th of February 2020. With this, a total of 150 students of West Sikkim have been sent on exposure and learning tour under the Explore and Learn initiative of the West District Administration. The entire initiative of the District Administration is being funded by REC Foundation through its CSR initiative. The idea of student exposure program is to further encourage them to move beyond their comfort zones and to be competitive in the world outside. This much for today. We'll be back with the more updates. Thank you.